I'm Deborah Walton. I'm the Chief Content Officer at Thomson Reuters, and I was flying back from San Francisco to get here this morning to welcome you, but didn't quite have worked that way. So I just wanted to say a few words of support and welcome to Thomson Reuters facility here. I was actually chatting up front, so I just thought I would tell you a little bit about what I was doing for the last 2 days. I was actually at Dreamforce. Has anyone here been to Dreamforce? Awesome, right? So Dreamforce is Salesforce's big annual sort of shindig in San Francisco. And I went for the first time this year. 140,000 people at Dreamforce. Thousands of companies with huge expo centers. It is absolutely mind-blowing. There's clothes off the streets in San Francisco. The main keynote, Marc Benioff, who many of you probably know as the CEO of Salesforce, he started Salesforce 15 years ago, obviously as a CRM, sort of in the cloud tool, and has built really CRM as a platform. And 10 years ago, he launched Dreamforce as a conference for partners, and today it's 140,000 people with such a attraction that Hillary Clinton opened the event. Michael Lewis, who wrote Moneyball, was one of the speakers. I was sitting there in Marc Benioff's keynote, and all of a sudden the lights came up on the stage and the Beach Boys started to play. I was like, oh my God, that is so cool. You know, they were launching and showcasing all wearable technologies now, where all the CRM, you know, they talk about how Marc Benioff will say, I do my phone is my office, and now it's like my watch is becoming my office with wearable technologies. And then they got the CEO of Coca-Cola Berlin on stage to talk about what they were doing with Service Cloud and how they were managing all of their distribution through Service Cloud. And all of a sudden, in comes a drone carrying cans of Coke and landed them on the stage. So I'm sitting there going, oh my God, my head is spinning. I had just gone out to Silicon Valley a couple of months ago and we did a big data tour, and I sat at the airport coming back and I put a post up on Facebook and I said, I'm going back to New York where I can pretend that the world is not changing. You know, you go out to California, it kind of really blows you away. So anyway, so why am I telling you all of this about Salesforce? I was thinking, actually, as I was walking in here this morning, we had the privilege of hosting this conference. Some of you may have been here last year. And I walked in this morning and I saw the banners downstairs with all of the sponsors and the partners, and I was like, wow. And then I saw my colleague Tim Baker and he said, wow, you should see it. They've really outgrown that space up there. And I started thinking about, wow, that's pretty cool. I've just come from this 140,000 person conference that started with a couple of hundred people 10 years ago. And I started to think about those parallels, really. What Benioff did with Salesforce, he democratized CRM. You know, he democratized software by putting software in the cloud, really enabling a mom and pop organization to really leverage and get the benefits of real industrial strength, you know, enterprise technologies to drive their business. And the whole business has grown around this ecosystem of partners and companies that have a vested interest in working together to evolve that. And it just struck me, and it might sound fanciful, but I always believe you have to have a big vision. It struck me that that's kind of what was happening here with the whole crowdfunding industry. You know, the world is forever changing, and those of us who sit and think that, you know, the lending industry will stay the way that it has been forever, obviously not the case. And I can feel here, I was reading up on a lot of the things that have been happening in the industry since last year, and there's no question there's incredible momentum. I mean, you only just have to look at the number of partners that are really coming in and the activity that's starting to happen in this space. So I just want to say, you know, I encourage all of you to really embrace the change, embrace the innovation. I want to say it's a real privilege at Thomson Reuters to play a small part in the development of this industry. You know, we have to think about how we change. We operate some of the world's largest liquidity venues in the world. We're probably the largest information company across all businesses in the world. And increasingly now, we have a huge business servicing the whole KYC challenge for many of our customers. So I think there are lots of ways for us to also adapt what we do to support this industry, and we're really keen to partner with many of you to do this. So I'd just like to say a big congratulations to you, Luan, for having the vision, for really the vision and the courage. And those of you in the room who are doing similar things, my congratulations to all of you, and thank you for sharing this conference with us. Thank you.